Hello students, today we continue with Act 2, Scene 1, page 65 onwards. The verse of Francisco, who says, "Sir, he may live. I saw him beat the surges under him, and ride upon their backs he trod the water whose enmity he flung aside, and breasted the surge most swollen that met him. His bold head above the contentious waves he kept, and roared himself with his good arms in lusty stroke to the shore, that over his wave-worn bases bowed. As stooping to relieve him, I not doubt he came alive to land." Now in this verse, Francisco, he says, or he responds to the question is, what strange fish has swallowed Ferdinand? In response to that, he gives the reply that he may be living. And he is giving the explanation, saying that he saw him beat the surges under him. Beating the surges means fighting against the waves and floating on the water. He was struggling in the water. He battled against the strong waves. He pushed himself with vigorous strokes of his strong arms, and he managed to swim towards the shore. Okay, so it's told over here that with the strokes of his strong arms, he was capable to reach towards the shore. That over his wave-worn bases bowed, as stooping to relieve him, I not doubt he came alive to land. So it's been told over here that when he reached the shore, his condition was worn out. He was completely worn out. But Francisco is sure that he managed to reach the shore safely. So he's sure that he reached the sea coast safely. Alonso then says, no, he's gone. That means Alonso does not trust whatever Francisco has told him. Sebastian, sir, you may thank yourself for this great loss that would not bless our Europe with your daughter, but rather lose her to an African, where she at least is banished from your eye, who hath cause to wet the grief on it. Now Sebastian, what is he saying? You may thank yourself for this great loss. That means you yourself is responsible for such a great loss. You over here refers to Alonso. Alonso himself is responsible for such a great loss. Now why he is responsible according to Sebastian? Because he has got his daughter married to an African. Okay, he has got his daughter married to an African. And that's why she's very far away from his eyes. What issue? According to Sebastian, Alonso should have been wise enough and he should have got his daughter married to a European prince. Okay. So, since he has got his daughter married to the African prince, he is responsible for such a great loss, where she at least is banished from your eye, who hath cause to wet the grief on it. So thus now your eyes have some cause to shed tears of grief. Alonso, Priti Peace, is requesting for peace. Sebastian, you were kneeled to and importuned otherwise by all of us, and the fair soul herself weighed between lothness and obedience, at which end, oh, the beam should bow. We have lost your son. I fear forever Milan and Naples have more widows in them of his business making than we bring men to comfort them, the faults your own. Now Sebastian is saying here, you were kneeled to and importuned otherwise by all of us. So it means what? All of us knelt and requested you to follow a different course of action. Okay, Sebastian is saying that all of us knelt before you and requested you to follow a different course of action. Then he's saying here about your daughter herself divided between unwillingness and desire to obey you, did not know which option to take. So you were actually at fault. You were actually at fault. This is what Sebastian is saying. Alonso was actually at fault. Because what, why he was at fault? Because he's responsible for the division between unwillingness and desire to obey him. Now it's being told that we have lost your son. Lost your son forever. Milan and Naples have more widows in them of this business making. So it's being told over here that the number of widows is more in Milan and Naples. Made by this enterprise than we have men to console them. Now this, for this you have to remember that men, most of the, according to the situation, most of the men, they are wrecked. They are wrecked or they have lost their lives. So it's being told that men in this enterprise, the number of widows are more and men are less to comfort or console them. It is your fault, Alonso's fault. Alonso, so is the dearest or the loss. Okay, so he's saying that because of my fault, I have suffered the greatest loss. Gonzalo, my Lord Sebastian, the truth you speak doth lack some gentleness and time to speak it in. You rub the sword when you should bring the plaster. Now Gonzalo is telling to Sebastian, he's first addressing him as my Lord Sebastian. What is he saying? The truth you speak, whatever truth you have spoken, it sounds that it lacks gentleness. Okay, and this is not the time to speak such a thing. This is what Gonzalo says. You rub the sore. Rubbing the sore means you are adding pain when you should bring the plaster. So at this particular moment, what has to be done? It's not the time to aggravate the pain, or it is not the time to add pain. Rather, it is the time to treat the sore. It is the time to treat the sore. Very well, Antonio, and most chirurgeonly. Now, chirurgeonly means the surgeon. Okay, surgeon. Antonio is referring him as you are acting like a surgeon. Okay, to cure. Surgeons, they were held inferior to physicians in Shakespearean time. In Shakespearean times, surgeons were held inferior to physicians. But over here, Antonio is saying that you are acting like a surgeon to cure the king's wound. Gonzalo, it is foul weather in us all. Good sir, why, when you are cloudy. So, it is foul weather, sad. It is gloomy, it is sad. For all of us, when you are, good sir, when you are cloudy, that means when you are sad. Foul weather. Antonio, very foul. So, foul weather refers to gloominess. Gloominess or sadness. Gonzalo, had I plantation of this isle, my lord. So, plantation of the isle means colonization. So, if I had the right to colonize this island, Antonio, he would sow it with needle seed. Okay, sow it with needle seeds. Now, needle seeds are the seeds of thorny plants. Sebastian, or docks or mallows. So, he means to say here, or docks. These are the weedy herbs and mallows are the wild plants. So, Sebastian says over here that he would plant either the herbs or the wild plants here. And were the king on it, what would I do? Suppose if the king was present on this island, what would I do? This is the question he is asking. Escape being drunk for want of wine. So, it is being told over here, Sebastian tells that in such a condition, he should escape being drunk because there is no wine. Gonzalo, either commonwealth I would by contraries execute all things for no kind of traffic. Would I admit no name of magistrate, letters should not be known, riches, poverty and use of service, none contract succession, bond, bound of land, tilt, vineyard, none, no use of metal, corn or wine or oil, no occupation, all men idle, all and women too, but innocent and pure, no sovereignty. This verse of Gonzalo, I will explain in the next video. So, I have completed the explanation till Sebastian telling that Gonzalo should abstain from wine to avoid drunkenness because there is no wine. We stop here.